Boundary and Annexation Survey, or BAS Partnership Toolbox 3, Reviewing BAS Updates. This video will demonstrate how to review change polygons for required U.S. Census Bureau criteria and attributes, and how to use the Attribute Check tool located in the BAS Partnership Toolbox. Before sending a BAS submission, participants should review all change polygons to ensure that they are intentional and correct. All change polygons should maintain important boundary to feature relationships found within the Census Bureau's database. The Census Bureau's spatial data is topologically integrated. This means that changes to a boundary may affect other features, such as roads or rivers. Participants should snap boundaries to street center lines where applicable. This will help establish a more accurate housing and population count for governments. In this example, there is a less than 30-foot gap between the green boundary correction and the road center line. In these instances, participants should snap the boundary change to the street center line. Otherwise, the population might be assigned to the incorrect government. The Census Bureau will not accept boundary corrections that create less than a 30-foot gap or overlap between an existing boundary and street center lines. In this example, the small spatial boundary corrections would dissolve the boundary to feature relationship with multiple streets. Participants should note that in the event a boundary change results in a less than 30-foot gap or overlap, the Census Bureau snaps the boundary to the street center line. The Census Bureau will also not accept boundary corrections that dissolve the current relationship between an existing boundary and linear feature without specific instruction that the relationship is incorrect. In this example, the boundary correction dissolves the relationship between the boundary and the river. If the feature itself is wrong, the Census Bureau will take the corrections and will realign the feature or boundary to the correct location using imagery. Participants should ensure all change polygons include the required attribution. All legal boundary changes, such as annexations and de-annexations, require the name of the government with updates, a legal documentation number, such as a law or ordinance number, the change type, an effective date for the change, and an authorization type. Boundary corrections that are not the result of a legal boundary change only require the name of the government with updates, the change type, and the relationship type to the government, for example, whether it should be included within the boundary or removed from the boundary. After reviewing all change polygons for spatial accuracy, Partnership Toolbox users can use the Attribute Check tool to verify there are no inconsistencies with the data included in the submission. Keep in mind that users may need to run this tool for all levels of geography that have changes since it runs on each individual change file. To get started, double-click the Attribute Check tool. The Attribute Check window opens. In the Change File field, select the folder icon to navigate to the location of the change file created using the Create Changes tool. In the Geography Type field, use the drop-down menu to select the type of geography to work on. This drop-down menu includes the same options as the Create Changes tool. The last input is the optional checkbox for Includes Changes in Georgia and only needs checking if responding in the state of Georgia. Once all fields are populated, select OK. There should now be an Attribute Check text file in the working folder, which includes the appropriate geography type and contains all the discrepancies identified in the change file that need to be fixed. In this example, two of the change polygons are missing the effective date and legal documentation information, and one of the change polygons, a boundary correction, is missing the relationship information. For example, whether it is being added to or removed from the boundary. If the Attribute Check tool finds errors within the change file, the participant should return to their MXD file to fix the errors, then run the Attribute Check tool again. If the attribute check tool shows no errors, the participant is ready to export and submit their BAS updates. For assistance creating a digital BAS submission, refer to the Digital Responding Guide, which is available on the BAS website. Chapter 5, Section 5.6 provides instructions on reviewing changes to the Census Bureau shapefiles. The Partnership Toolbox Overview document, included with the toolbox download, provides step-by-step instructions for using the Attribute Check tool. For BAS support, please contact the Census Bureau by phone toll-free at 1-800-972-5651 or by email at geo.bass@census.gov. Participants may also refer to the BAS website for resources.